Greetings to all. Welcome to Learning Management System. I'm Shabana SS, lecturer in Electronics and Communication Department, Government Polytechnic, Ballari. Today we'll start the session 3 of unit 6. In the previous session, session 2, we studied about the employment opportunities in garment sector, public and private sector. Also, we saw about the government opportunities in technical area, management and marketing area. In today's session, we'll study about the employment searching and also the different sources of recruitment, that is internal and external source of recruitment. So let's start the today's session and discuss about the employment searching method. We all are quite familiar, the main methods of employment searching is via daily newspapers, that is through their classified jobs column or job advertising page. Employment News is an exclusive newspaper that covers job offers of especially central government department and the public sector openings. In spite of newspaper awareness, today all the unemployed youths can search for better employment opportunities online through websites. This is the most popular method nowadays. For example, Naukri.com, TimesJob.com and many more provide better job searching. In addition to job searching on newspapers and websites, there exist good number of consultants who provide placement services. Also, companies such as Infosys, Wipro, BHEL, that is Bharat Heavy Electricals Limited, and Bell, Bharat Electronics Limited, conduct campus interviews at various polytechnics and engineering colleges. Every college will have a placement cell. Once the student comes to the final year or the fifth semester, then the placement officer will invite number of companies to the college campus. So these companies will conduct written tests and interviews and choose suitable candidates for their companies. Also, government departments offer job vacancies through KPSC, UPSC employment notifications and through employment exchange office. The candidate has to get registered himself in the employment exchange office. So they will inform based on the qualification and experience of the candidate. They will inform if any vacancies are available. Hence, nowadays, employment searching is not a tedious job and readily one will get to know where and how exactly to find a job offer and how to apply for a particular post. The next main topic of this session is sources of recruitment. So before going to the sources of recruitment, we'll just see what is the definition of recruitment. Recruitment is the process of actively seeking out, finding and hiring the candidates for a particular position or job. Recruitment is also defined as a process of employing new people to work for a company or an organization. It is one of the challenging tasks for the personnel managers. Vacancies will occur in any company or organization when someone leaves the organization or as a result of company expansion. Now let's come to the different sources of recruitment. So recruitment can be divided into two main categories. The first one is internal sources of recruitment. Second one, external sources of recruitment. So we'll discuss one by one. First, let's see what are the different internal sources of recruitment available. Internal sources of recruitment means recruiting the employee within the organization. This is implemented through the various processes of promotions, transfers, departmental exams, retirement, and former employees. So let's just discuss one by one. The first one is promotions. Promotion is defined as a movement to a higher position where the responsibilities, rights, and as well as the prestige of an employee will be increased. Promotion policy is followed as a motivation for the employees who work hard and show good performance in their career. Many organizations have systematic promotion plans as per the seniority. Promotion is an in-service benefit given to an employee who is already working in an organization or a company. Getting promoted to a higher post from the available post, whichever the employee is working, is almost like a big achievement for any of the employee working in private sector or government sector. Now, in simple terms, promotions andre like mumbadti niruvudara moolaka hosa huddege nemakati. The next method of internal source of recruitment is transfers. Transfers andre ondu sthaladinda mattondu sthalakke illadare bere kacherige vargavane moolaka huddege bharti maadikolluvudu. Transfer suggests that an existing employee should go and join the work at a different place other than the existing place. It involves shifting of an employee from one department to another whenever the post becomes vacant. There may be change in responsibilities, duties, and also salary after an employee receives transfer. Sometimes the employees will not be happy with the transfer. They resist the transfer as they might not be interested to quit the existing workplace. This may be due to their personal inconvenience or fear to discharge their duties at the transferred place. The next source of internal source of recruitment is departmental exams. Departmental exams may be conducted to search a suitable candidate for a particular job. This is done if there is competition in the department itself. Now the next one is retirements, which is also one of the internal source of recruitment. Now how does retirement of employees become an internal source of recruitment? Retirement means vayonivrutti hondidavarannu punaha kelasakke tegedukolluvudu. That means the retired employees may be given extension in their service in case any suitable candidate is not available for the post. The next and the last reason is former employees. Former employees is also one of the method of internal sources of recruitment. The former employees who had performed well during their service, they may be called back and higher wages and incentives can be paid to them. Former employees andre ee hinde seve sallisi bittu hogiruva udyogigalannu maru nemakati maadikolluvudu. So another reason also we can include, that is internal advertisement. So company kacheriyalli udyogakkagi jahiratu prakatisuvudu. So these all are the internal sources of recruitment. Among these, the first two, that is promotions and transfers, usually the question on explain about promotions and transfers related to employment. So usually this question will occur in the question paper. So what are the benefits of internal source of recruitment? Just let us have a look on this. The existing employees will get motivated by internal source of recruitment, because transfers or promotions, this is one of the internal source of recruitment. So by, especially by promotion, the existing employee will get motivated. It is like encouraging the employee. And also by internal source of recruitment, cost will be saved as there is no need to give advertisements about the vacancies. The internal source of recruitment also builds loyalty among the employees towards the organization. And also the training cost is saved as the employees already know about the nature of job to be performed. Then internal source of recruitment, it is a reliable and very simple process. Now, this method of internal source of recruitment also has some limitations, like the young people with the knowledge of modern technology and innovative ideas will not get the chance. Also, the performance of existing employees may not be as efficient as before. And also, it may bring down the morale of employees who will not get promotion or selected. It may lead to favoritism in the organization or company. It may not always be in the good interest of the organization. These are the few limitations. Next, let us see about the external sources of recruitment. When large vacancies are to be filled, external sources of manpower are preferred. The main sources of external recruitments are as mentioned below. The very popular method of press advertisement, then campus interviews, placement agencies, employment exchange, walk-in interviews, e-recruitment, competitors, etc. All these are the different sources of recruitment, that is external recruitment. So let us discuss these different sources one by one. The first one is press advertisement. A wide choice for selecting the appropriate or suitable candidate for the post is made available through this source. Press advertisement gives wide publicity to the vacant post and also the details about the job in the form of job description and job specification are made available to the public in general. The second popular source of external recruitment is campus interviews. This is the best possible method for the companies to select students from various educational institutions. It is very simple or easy and also economical for the companies or organization. The company officials personally visit various institutes and select the students eligible for a particular post through written tests or interviews. Students get a good opportunity to prove themselves and get selected for a good job. The next third one is placement agencies. A database of all the candidates is sent to the organizations for their selection purpose and the agencies get commission in return. Placement agencies or it may be consultants. The next reason is employment exchange. People register themselves with government employment exchanges with their personal details. All the details like qualification, experience if any, and if they have done any extra courses related to that branch or any other general computer knowledge courses, that should be informed in the employment exchange. So according to the needs and request of the organization, the suitable candidates will be sent for the interviews. The next one is walk-in interviews. These interviews are declared by the companies on the specific day and time and conducted for selection. The candidate has to be present at the location mentioned by the company officials and attend the interview or written test at the specified date and time. The next most popular method is e-recruitment. Various sites such as jobs.com, naukri.com, monster.com and number of sites are available on which the candidates can upload their resume and search for the jobs. Then competitors. By offering better terms and conditions of service, the human resource managers will try to get the employees working in their competitors' organization. So all these are the different sources of external recruitment. Now let us see what are the benefits of these external sources of recruitment. So the first main benefit is new talents will get the opportunity. Then the best selection is possible as a large number of candidates will apply for the job. Then in case the suitable candidates are not available within the organization, then it is better to select them from the outside sources. So then this external recruitment process will also have some limitations, like skilled and ambitious employees may switch the job more frequently. It gives a sense of insecurity among the existing candidates. It also increases the cost as advertisement has to be given through press and training facilities should be provided for the new candidates. Now let us see the multiple choice questions related to recruitment and as well as external source and internal source of recruitment. The first one, which of the following is not an external source of recruitment? So the options given are A, campus recruitment, B, promotion, C, casual callers, and D, direct recruitment. So the right answer, so what is asked in the question is, among the following, which method is not an external source of recruitment? So the right answer is B, that is promotion. Promotion, as we know, it is an internal source of recruitment. The remaining three, like campus recruitment, casual callers, and direct recruitment, all these three are external source of recruitment. The next question is, it is a good source of filling the vacancies with employees from overstaffed departments. So the options given are A, promotion, B, transfers, C, placement agencies, and D, government agencies or government exchanges. So which is the right answer? The right answer is B, that is transfers. That means transfer is one of the method to fill the vacancies from any department where the staff are in excess. From that department where staff are in excess, the employees will be transferred to any other department where requirement is there. The next question is, which of the following is an internal source of recruitment? The options are casual callers, advertising on television, then transfers, and labor contractors. So among this, you have to tell which is an internal source of recruitment. So the right answer is C, that is transfers. The remaining three, that is casual callers, advertising on television, labor contractors, all this will come under external sources. Transfers is one of the internal source of recruitment. The next question. The various activities involved in the process of recruitment include the first option, identification and assessment of the different sources of recruitment. B, selecting the most suitable source or sources. Then C, inviting applications from prospective candidates. Or D, all of the above. Now what is asked is, in the process of recruitment, what are the different steps or activities to be followed? So the right answer is D, all the above. That is, for the process of recruitment includes first, identification and assessment of what are the available sources. Then after that, selecting. After identifying which are the sources, then selection should be done. Which source is suitable for the company or organization? After deciding which source to follow, that is external or internal, the next thing what they have to do, they have to invite the application from the prospective candidates. So all these are the different steps they follow in the process of recruitment. Now the next question is about promotion. Promotion of an employee will lead to, the options are A, shifting an employee to a higher position, B, entrusting higher responsibilities, then C, increase in status, D, all of the above. So the right answer is D. That means whenever promotion is given to an employee, it will actually shift an employee to a higher position. From the present position, he will be shifted to a higher position. That means his designation will be increased. Then he will be also given more responsibilities along with promotion, and even his status will also increase. So all these three are right. So the right answer will be D, all of the above. So next question, when the employees are given promotion, there A, motivation level improves, B, loyalty increases, C, job satisfaction level is higher, or D, all of the above. Now tell me the right answer. The right answer is D. Whenever promotion is given to an employee, definitely he will be motivated, he will be encouraged, and he will improve further in his service. And he will become more loyal to the organization, company or institution. And also his job satisfaction level will be increased or will become higher. So the right answer is D, all of the above. The next question. The following test or this test is an indicator of a person's learning ability or the ability to make decisions and judgments. A, trait test. B, personality test. C, intelligence test. Or D, aptitude test. So just guess what will be the right answer. Here, the question is about, you have to tell which is the test which will test the person's learning ability or decision making capacity or judgment making capacity. The suitable test for this particular ability is intelligence test. The right answer is C, intelligence test. The next MCQ, it is a measure of individual's potential for learning new skills. Option A is trait test, B, personality test, C, intelligence test, or D, aptitude test. So now here, the test will be related to individual's potential or capacity to learn new skills. So that test is nothing but aptitude test. So the right answer is D, aptitude test. The next question is related to the process of recruitment. So here, how many stages does the recruitment process comprise of? Option A is 2, B is 6, C 9, or D option is 5. So we have to tell in the process of recruitment, how many stages are there? So the right answer is D. There are 5 stages totally in the recruitment process. So what are those stages? Just I have covered it in the last question. Rearrange the following steps of recruitment. So the options are, first searching, second evaluation and control, third planning, fourth screening, fifth strategy development. So here the steps or the different steps of recruitment are arranged in a random manner. So what we have to do is arrange the steps in a proper sequence. So before going to the options and the right answer, so let me just tell you in brief what these steps mean. These steps of recruitment will be followed by the company who wants to appoint the suitable candidates for their company or organization. The first what we have listed is searching, simple process of searching the suitable candidate for their company. The next one is evaluation and control. So evaluation is gathering the job applicant's feedback. So it is actually the last step. Here effectiveness and validity of the total recruitment process and methods will be assessed. Planning, it is actually recruitment planning. This will determine the recruitment goals and it will check thoroughly before making a job offer. That means the company, when it is following the recruitment process, so first they have to plan what is their goal, for what purpose they are recruiting, what is the aim of their recruitment, for which suitable post, what is their requirement, that is qualification or experience in any particular field. So they have to plan that first, plan their goals first and then check thoroughly before making a job offer. Then screening. Screening is reviewing the job applications or resume and finding the closest applicant job description which matches with respect to qualification, experience, etc. Then strategy development. The recruitment strategy will set the unique position of the company on the job market. It is an approach to winning the best talent. So here different options A, B, C, D are listed. So directly I'll come to the right answer. It is B. Answer B is the right option. So here how should we arrange the steps is, first will come 3, third one, then fifth, first one, fourth and second one. So to understand the process, I have just put an image related to recruitment process. Here we can see the different steps in a proper sequence. So the first step is recruitment planning. They have to plan their goals. Then strategy development. After that, searching. Then screening the job applications or resume. Finally, evaluation and control process. The references for this particular unit 6 used are Organizational Management and Entrepreneurship by P.G. Mundas. Then Organizational Management and Entrepreneurship by V.S. Bhagat and Basic Management Skills and Indian Constitution by Rajesh Hongal. Also, I have just taken the help of the search engine Google to collect some data. So that's all for today's session. The remaining three sessions of this Unit 6 will be continued by Srimati Shailaja S.N. from Government Women's Polytechnic, Hassan. Thank you, one and all.